Hey guys, this is Chris here with Expedition Sim. I'm actually standing here with the guys from Bridgeify, and who are creating a really interesting way for you to actually talk to your friends without actually needing a Wi-Fi or internet signal. George, tell me how it works.
So basically the phones communicate directly between themselves, so you don't need to go through a third party like a satellite or a Wi-Fi router or a server. And the phones communicate over large distances by sending messages using their Bluetooth and Wi-Fi antennas directly to from one to another. So they hop until they get to the person that you're trying to reach.
So I'm piggybacking off of somebody else who's piggybacking off of somebody else who finally that last person may actually have a connection either to the internet or to a 4G network, correct?
Not necessarily, depending on the use case. For example, with using WhatsApp, you could be texting somebody that is really, really far away and nobody in any moment would need to have internet, but you would be piggybacking off of other people.
Okay, so you told me a little bit earlier about Uber. You know, so my Uber driver, he's going to have a signal because,
right,
of course, he's got to take our payments and make sure that we've got all the money, and he knows where he's got to know where I am.
Right.
But if I don't have signal, so my signal, my location, and my request is all
right,
all of that's going to piggyback
exactly
across the chain.
So let's say you travel, you come visit us in Mexico City, and you don't have access to data, so you would open up your Uber app, and the Uber app sends the signal to all the people around you, so it would piggyback off of other Uber users until it reaches a driver, and then the driver would process the reception of the ride. He would come pick you up because you already sent him your location, and then when he finishes the ride, he would conclude it and process the payment, but you would in no moment need to have access to internet.
Okay, so I'll still be able to get all the information of like who my driver is, what kind
exactly
of car he has, the license plate number,
yep,
and all that.
Yeah, everything.
Now, you also mentioned something interesting about natural disasters. How would this work in a case of an earthquake or phone systems are down?
Okay, so right after a natural disaster, let's say an earthquake or a flood, a lot of the lines are down, you know? So people don't have access to communication. They can't be found, or they can't find their family or their friends. So with our technology, all they would need to do is open up their WhatsApp or maybe a United Nations app or whatever, and just send out their location and send out messages so people would be able to be found regardless of what just happened.
So now, this isn't something that I as a consumer am going to go download. You're working more with communication partners, right? No,
exactly. So we want to partner with big apps like Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp, Uber, Lyft, because they already have the user density that we need. So with a simple update, you could just go to the App Store, update WhatsApp, and then suddenly, okay, now you can use it without internet. So you don't need to actually learn how to use a different app. Just keep using the apps that you love, but now you can use them where previously you couldn't.
Now, one tough question for you is, by having that push update, now it does open a little privacy concerns of my data and anything that, because of the piggyback, now I've got multiple devices in between me and the endpoint. How do we overcome some of the privacy concerns and encryption? How do we make sure that communication can't be captured by a man in the middle?
Right. So it's all encrypted. We use PGP, which is public keys included. So basically, the message that you send can only be read by the person that you're sending it to. It would be really, really complicated to be intercepted by somebody in the middle, and even if it were, they wouldn't be able to read it. So we're really, really focused on making this as secure as possible.
Excellent. Well, folks, this is Bridgeify. You will hear more about them in the future with your app updates. When you look at your Facebook Messenger, you said WhatsApp,
Tinder, Snapchat.
Tinder. Oh my gosh, Tinder. No,
whatever that is.
No se que dime. But Jorge, thank you much. Check out bridgeify.me. That's the website, www.bridgeify.me.